Hello, welcome to the power sequencer of our housekeeping MCU training series. In this video, we will demonstrate how to use an MSP430 MCU to configure the power on sequence of four power rails in a super easy way. Many systems require a variety of voltages to power the ASICs, FPGAs, etc. They require voltages to power on in a specific sequence, less damage to the chip will occur. In this example, the MCU stays in low power mode and waits for a folding edge on the enabled pin. After the MCU wakes up, the two timers with two comparators each can generate interrupts at every power on moment. On the easy-to-use graphical interface or GUI, users can detect the current sequence and modify it for the next time. Since the modified sequence is stored in frame, there is no worry about the data loss even after reset. First, let's discuss the system overview, including the hardware connections needed. For this example on the MSP430FR2433 Launchpad, pin P1.0 is used to light up the LED when the code starts up. Pin P2.3 is used to detect the enable signal by switch. Four other pins are applied to output the power on signals to enable four power converters. The code uses the internal clock, so the crystal is not connected to the chip. The launchpad's backchannel UART is used to communicate with the host GUI. Please make sure the TSD and XD jumpers are populated on the jumper blocks. Let's discuss a flowchart of the basic sample code. In the main program, after initialization, the MCU enters low power mode and waits for the interrupt request, triggered by an enable signal from port 2. When the enable interrupt is requested, the MCU starts the two timers and waits for timer interrupt. When the timer comes up to the compare register TACCR, the timer interrupt is requested. The output pin connected to the corresponding converter is set high. After all of the power converters are powered on, the timer stops and the total power on sequence is shown gray. Users can modify the sequence for the next time. The data is stored in frame, which will be applied to initiate the timers after reset. Let's take a look at the GUI. Overall, it includes three sections, that is, four sliders, five LEDs, and two rows of text boxes. By default, all LEDs light off and all data is cleared. Once press the switch on the launchpad, the enable LED lights up and the timer starts to count. When the timer interrupt is requested, the LED of corresponding power lights up, and the slider shows the time interval between the enable moment and power on moment. After all converters are powered on, the total sequence is shown in the text boxes on the right of the current. The sequence for the next time can be altered in the talk boxes on the right of Modify. Users can input the time interval from 1 to 1000 milliseconds. Thanks for watching the video. Go ahead and try out the provided GUI yourself and check out the code example. The technical note is available to read for more design details. We hope you enjoy this video and come back for other MSP430 housekeeping topics. Have a great day and happy engineering!